Thank you, Director Watt, and thanks for the shout out, Iris. And let me say good morning to each one of you. I will be brief. I am Gloria Jean Sweetlove, and I am a lifelong advocate. As a matter of fact, my sons say if I had not gotten married so early, I would be one of those people that would be somewhere teaching in a missionary school somewhere else. But since I don't do that, what I do every day, and I'm proud to say I do, is I advocate for others. Because Reverend, when I get to the gate, I don't want St. Peter to say there's any reason that I shouldn't get in. But this morning, one of my other presidents were here, Mr. Monroe Wood, and he talked about advocating for health care and other issues, and about the fact that a lot of time in the rural, people really, really don't have access. We live in an age of smartphones and internet access and et cetera. But when you talk about a small rural community that whose library internet may or may not work today, and a lot of times the staff can't help assist you with it, and they don't have an own staff IT person, it's real. Let me get to what I was gonna talk about, and Beverly, I promise you I'm gonna finish early. I want to talk about two or three issues. I want to talk about workplace discrimination. I want you to know that Tennessee's antiquated labor laws continue to foster job discrimination. We are seeing an increasing number of race, gender, and age discrimination complaints. We are also seeing co-employment claims from workers who are under contract by temporary agents, and you know that's the new things. Workers are experiencing outright racist remarks and treatment by employers and supervisor of an employing company. The young lady this morning, Debbie, I believe, and for Women's Rights, talked about how students are being harassed sexually. We're seeing workers with those same kind of complaints, but workers who can't quit. The employment at will laws allows employers to dismiss employees without notice or reason. And we are seeing a revolving door of supervisors using fear and retaliation to coerce workers to work off the clock, work outside of their defined job skill, just to keep a minimum wage job. Female employees are accepting sexual harassment and offensive behavior because they state, I need to work. We're talking about black and brown people who need any kind of job just to stay afloat, who can't say, I won't take that, because they've got children at home to feed. They got a mortgage. They got to try to keep a roof over their head. This is happening frequently, but employees are living in economic slavery because of the economy. They can't quit or have no marketable skills. The checking of the box to determine if you're an ex-felon or have jail times continue to shut out countless applicants before they can complete the application or discuss any prior job experience. Even among people that might have worked in that particular a workplace prior to having a felony. So that is an issue that is really, really hurting people that are needing employment. We are continuing to see companies union busting or retaliate against employers who think they may be interested in a union. We are seeing companies locking out union employees, failing to give them a new contract, allowing them to work out to be replaced with contract laborers. Racial profiling is still alive and well. We have to do something about that. And we, the average citizen, have to stand up and complain that this is not right. Although NASA did not renew its contract with the Department of Homeland Security, and the use of the 287G rule resulted not in the deportation of undesirable, undocumented individuals as designed, but in a reign of terror that deported more than 10,000 black and brown individuals for simple misdemeanors such as driving without a license or lottery. And we're still seeing the effect of that. We're still seeing and hearing and feeling that. And we still see people, Iris just talked to you about young people that won't really, really, really want a work permit, but really, really, really don't want to go down and tell people who I am. There are not a lot of cities in Tennessee where you got a mayor like Warden that said, came forth and said, I want to build this coalition and I want to make sure that people are treated right. And, you know, because we all got here, unless you like my great-grandfather that was born here because he was a Cherokee Indian, we all our other were immigrated from somewhere. So it is about all of us living together. In education, and I know Tamika's going to talk some on education, let me quickly hit a couple of things. School voucher, Governor Haslam and the legislators continue to push to expand charter schools and to make vouchers available to be used for private school. We're seeing complaints relative to this. While we see education funding drying up every day, there's no money, but they continue to push that. We believe that any school who receives public dollars should be available to all children, not just those with high scores on achievement tests. And lastly, the achievement school districts. The state's achievement school districts continue to wreak havoc and disrupt school and community life for those in low-income urban areas. And I don't want the rural people and other folks to get excited about it because it's coming to you also. They use them all to say if your school has been underachieving for a number of years, then they can, the achievement district can take it over. And it is not helping us. The rigidness and lack of culture sensitivity, along with the lack of culture diversity of many of the staff and administrators of these schools, can be equated to a hostile takeover of education. We continue to feel complaints of lack of sensitivity to bathroom breaks, children waiting outside in the cold for staff to arrive because gates and doors are locked and they're forbidden to use alternate entry, and other issues that show a lack of care and understanding for urban children. Thank you for your time. Thank you for conducting these hearings. And please do let us know whatever we can do. Try to make a difference.